Hello everyone! In this video I'm going to show you again how to grow your own crystals and make beautiful druzy molds out of them. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of, in this case silicon molds making, or resin art or acrylics, mixed media and a lot more other tutorials, consider to subscribe. Click the notification bell and select all, because if you select all, then you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So I already started with adding the wood glue onto the bottom and the sides of my plastic base molds. And you need a water resistant wood glue, because I got a lot of questions which glue I'm using. But you need a water resistant wood glue, because you add the salt and water mixture on top. So that's why you need a water resistant wood glue. And the base molds I'm using in this video, I got from Inge. She is a Dutch person. Dutch girl, and she has her own Etsy shop where she sells these amazing plastic base molds, and the link to her Etsy shop is below this video in the description box, and her Etsy shop is called Silicon Molds Studio. So if you're interested in her amazing plastic base molds to grow your own crystals in, then the link to her Etsy shop is below this video. And I want to thank Inge so much for sending me these amazing molds. And I can't tell you how much I appreciate it, Inge. Because, I like these base molds very much. Because you can use them more than once. It's not only one time use. It's more than once, because the first molds I got from her, I still use. So, and I've made about 20 molds already in them. So you can use them again if you are careful with it. So not only handling it, but also when you take out the silicon molds. So the first one was a geode shape base mold, and that mold is about 7 by 11 centimeters. The one I'm working on now is 13 centimeters, so it's a nice size for a coaster. And you can see I'm adding the wood glue on the bottom, but now also on the sides, so that I have a nice sparkly edges on my silicon mold. And I also like these base molds, but because you can use them for all, so you grow your own crystals in it, but you pour the silicon rubber in the same mold. So I think that's a great idea. And very easy to use. So I added the alum salt into the plastic base mold, and now I'm tapping on the sides to make sure that the wood glue is totally covered with the alum salt. Yeah, I'm using alum salt, but I think you can also use Epsom salt. I got some comments below my other video. I've not done that myself. And I got some comments that you can also use borax. I don't know what it is, but I think you can buy it in the USA. But yeah, I'm using the alum salt, and I will include some links below this video of which salt I'm using. So now I'm working on a larger base mold, and this one is 20 centimeters, so a very nice size. Sorry. Yeah, and when you make your own druzy molds, then you can use those druzy silicon molds in another silicon mold to create that nice crystal effect. But you can also use these inlay druzy molds on top of your last layer of resin. I've done that one time. I think I also made a video of it in a geode tray where I used the stars on top of my last resin layer, and it also gives me a nice effect. There you can see it. I'm adding the alum salt again in the base mold. Tapping onto the sides. There you can see it. And the excess I throw back into my jar. Yeah, and this is a long process. And it's a lot of waiting time because you need to let everything dry before you can go to the next step. So if you rush, then you will not grow your crystals. So we are 24 hours later, what I already mentioned, you need to wait a lot. So we are 24 hours later and the wood glue is dry. Now I'm going to add the first time the salt water mixture. And so you can see the water is hot because I also got some questions about that. I boiled 400 milliliters of water. And now I'm going to add 100 gram of alum salt. But the rule is that you need to add salt as long as it dissolves in the water. If it doesn't dissolve anymore, then you have enough in your water. So now I'm mixing it around. Adding more of the alum salt. And I also got some questions if I can use this mixture for second time or third time. Yes, you can. You can boil it again. And I always check if I can add more alum salt to it, but you can use it again. So you don't have to make every time a new mixture. I'm so sorry again for my French bulldogs. I keep saying that every time I make a video, but they are so noisy when I do the voiceover. But yeah, I hope you don't mind. So there's enough salt in it. Yeah, my friend's builder is playing with his ball. So that's why he makes such noise. So now you need to strain the mixture because if there still is salt in it, then you don't want that in your mixture. You need to strain it. There you can see it. So now I'm going to add it for the first time into the plastic base molds. There you can see it. Very carefully, all the way to the top. Yeah, and that's why you need a water resistant wood glue, because you add the mixture on top of it. And after I filled them, I place a piece of paper on top of it, not totally closed because there still need to be air coming into it. So again, we are 24 hours later and now we can see if the crystals already grown a little bit. But first, need to remove the water. Alum mixture, there you can see it. What I already mentioned, you can use this mixture again by boiling it and checking if you can add still some alum salt. And then you can add it again into the base molds. Making it dry a little bit with a paper towel. Make it very carefully. And yeah, the crystals have grown a little bit. And if you like this fine texture of crystals, then you are done. But I want the crystals to be a little bit larger, so that's why I'm going to add a second, for the second time, the mixture. And that's why I'm telling you this process is a long process, but I like doing this. I have so much fun. Now on to the larger base mold. Very carefully, making it dry with my paper towel. You can also already see the sparkle of the crystals a little bit. So this is a closer look after the first time I've added the alum water mixture. Yeah, the crystals have grown a little bit, you can see it, it sparkles a lot. But I want the crystals a little bit larger, so I will be adding a second mixture to it. But I want to show you how it looks after one time. There you can see the large base mold. Now I'm going to add for the second time the water alum mixture all the way to the top. I can see it. So it's the same process what I've shown you in the beginning of the video, how to make the mixture. 400 milliliters of water and 100 gram of alum salt. And that's, then you need to strain it and then add it into your base mold and let this set or sit for 24 hours. Again, a paper, piece of paper. And again, we are 24 hours later, and this is after the second time I've added the mixture. You can see the crystals are much larger now. Sparkles already a lot, looks great, but I'm still not satisfied. I will be adding for the third time a mixture to let the crystals grow a little bit more. Very nice. Again, we are 24 hours later, so I've added for the third time the mixture and removed the water, and now it looks like this, and I'm very pleased how it looks. So after three times of adding the mixture in the plastic base molds, yeah, the crystals have grown to this size, and I think it's okay for a druzy silicon mold. I need to let this dry before I can spray it with some gloss varnish. So now it's time to make the silicon molds. What I already mentioned, you need to spray the crystals with a gloss varnish, and I'm using the Motip gloss varnish, and I've added three thin layers, and again I let it dry for 24 hours, and now I can add the silicon rubber. You need to spray it because otherwise the crystals will break off. They are too soft. And to protect it, you need to spray it with a gloss varnish. So now I'm adding the silicon rubber into the base molds on top of the crystals. And I'm using about 300 gram of silicon rubber. Yeah, and I'm using a brand that I can buy here in the Netherlands, because I also got some questions about which silicon rubber I use. But you can use, I think you can buy the Moldstar out of, if you live out of Europe. Yeah, if you add it all the way to the top, the silicon rubber, then they are quite thick, I think 1 centimeter. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to fill them halfway so that they will be 6 millimeters, 6, 7. Because I want that nice crystal edge. And when you add the silicon rubber, you need to add it from up high in a thin stream, because then the air bubbles can come up, rise to the surface. Bit by bit, I'm adding the silicon rubber. Yeah, and for all silicon rubbers, it's different. This one needs to dry for at least 8 hours. But I remove them out of the base mold after 24 hours. Then I know for sure that they are totally dry. There you can see, bit by bit, I'm adding the silicon rubber. And also, if you want to make your own Drusy silicon molds, make sure your surface is level, because this silicon rubber will level out. So if your surface, your wood, your workbench or whatever is not level, then the silicon inlay molds will not be okay. Then one side will be thicker than the other side. So make sure your bench is level. So I'm almost done. Then after 24 hours, I can take them out of the mold. So we are 24 hours later, and now I can remove them out of the base mold. So very carefully, with a wooden stick, I'm taking them out. There you can see it. And also very carefully, I'm removing them from the crystals to make sure that the crystals don't break. And this one is okay, the base mold. I can use it again. Yeah, you can't see the sparkle that good. But at the end of this video, I will show you a close-up. Then you can see the sparkle much better outside in the daylight. On to the larger one of 20 centimeters. And I can already see that I have some nice sparkly edges, so that's great. And I think this large one is about 5-6 millimeters thick, so that's good. So you can see, first removing the silicon drusy mold from the edge. There you can see it very carefully. And then to the center. And so you can see the base molds are still okay. I can use them again. Very nice, so sparkly. very pleased how they look. Now onto the geodesic shape. Hopefully this one will also come out very easy. This silicon druzy mold is a little bit thicker, I think 7 millimeters. But for me that's okay. And in another video I will show you how I use these silicon druzy molds. And that base mold is also okay. Yeah, I'm very pleased. Try to show you the sparkle from up close, there you can see it. Very nice. Also, the edges are very sparkly. That one is about 5 millimeters thick. And this one also. Very nice. Let me know what you think of my silicon druzy molds. If you like them or not. And hopefully I've inspired you all to grow your own crystals. Because it's so much fun. Now the geode shape, there you can see it, it's a little bit thicker. I think 7-8 millimeters. But that's okay. So this is how they look outside in the daylight, very sparkly. Hopefully you can see the sparkle. This is the large one of 20 centimeters. So nice. So if you are interested in the plastic base molds, the link to the Etsy shop of Inge Silicon Molds Studio is in the description box below this video. These base molds are amazing. So take a look at the description box or her Etsy shop. The link to my Etsy shop is also in the description box. You can find my natural mica pigments in my Etsy shop, but also mica flakes. And also I've added some abalone shells, some slices abalone shells, very nice. So and the Etsy shop to my associate Evelyn Schaefer in the USA, you can also find in the description box below this video. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up for this video if you like it. I want to thank you all for watching again, and hopefully I will see you in the next video. Bye!